I'm a dead foot. Okay? But I'm here. I want to push off. Okay, so look, if I'm doing this, I'm stepping lean foot. Okay? And it feels weird, doesn't it? If I'm here, I can keep pressure on him. I take the foot, let's look at the position of our hand. Here to here. Here to here. So if you're already getting away the center line, put your heel down. Okay, so now watch. Advance, trap the hip. Okay? He comes in. Advance, trap the hip. Okay? Now you gotta go stay with him. Okay? This is not what we're looking for. Sort of kind of maybe, but you're seeing the top end of the technique. Okay? The ability to actually do that doesn't come from your hand. It comes from able to close the gap explosively. Okay? You gotta keep this off the ground. So if you're here, you're doing this. Okay? I want to be here. I want to explode on the rear foot. Okay? And it's going to be over here. So you have to be back and right. Okay? Tear the pop side up, but make sure you're entering the rear foot. You're pushing off. Here we go. I want to put him in a position he can't respond to. So now, we're drilling to your lots of reps. You need to manage space and distance. Okay, now right, so from here, okay?
Yeah.
So from here, watch. Cock side up, heel side up. Okay, so look, I'm gonna go. Cock side up, he stops me here. From right here, I'm gonna slide into a finger jab. So right now, finger jab the chest. Here's what I don't want to do. I'm gonna lose it. So look, this is cash, and then pull back. So when I'm here, like a 1, 2, 3, I should still be what? See the pressure's going forward? So I've gotta trap the other hand I can attach to it, okay? I don't want to go trap 2, 3, everything's just cash. I've already wasted the time. So what? So 1, 2, 3, all pops out back right here. Boom. So right there. Bang! Or just finger jab. So if I lose this attachment, he just goes pop. Okay? So this way, so he's here, he can't do anything at all. I've already captured that. So that is the head back and you trap there. Okay? So go slow. We're adding one thing. The only reason I'm adding the heel salad there is to keep you on this guy's arm. Okay? I'm seeing, it's like, what? I want to see this. I want to see you staying aggressive on that guy's arm so you're not losing that attachment. Okay? So, pox out up with the dummy. Hit. Okay? So, pox out up, heel salad up. I'm pulling this finger out. That's the one I usually lead with. So I want to just going to stick this through. Okay, here we go. Both sides, go slow. Set, cross, look, cross, counter. What is that? It's a combination, right? But it's a combination in response to what he's doing. Does that make sense? What are we doing with traffic? We're responding to a certain reaction the person gives us. Does that make sense? So, if you memorize this procedure, are you really getting a good read of the response? And what you're looking for is someone who's in front of you who can give you the response you're looking to read the energy of them. Does that make sense? So you can memorize the trapping patterns, but if you don't come across the energy, the response, it's not going to feel right. Okay? So what is Pak Sao Do? What is Pak Sao Do? Overwhelming crash. Bang! That's what it is. Then it goes to the combination thing. What is Pak Sao Do Beal Do? It's there. It's okay. But that same thing is I respond to that. Okay, so even if I don't move back, maybe I block this. That's what's happening there. Is the Beal Sao is sneaking up underneath the Pak Sao. Okay? So if we go to the Pak Sao Do, Beal Sao Pak Sao Do, it's another range concept. He's here. He goes in traps. And I go across the center line. What's the heel sound? And I stop that. Now here's the thing. If I go way across there, that heel sound is going to score. So really, it's Pak Sao Do heel sound. So the number, the one I put in there. So Pak Sao Do heel sound is two facets. One is right there. He sneaks the heel sound up inside. That's Pak Sao Do heel sound, right? This is Pak Sao Do heel sound. I overreact. Bam! Slams the Beal Sao in there. Does that make sense? So, okay? And your partner's got to be able to kind of feed you that to make it actually work. Okay, now, so Hawk Sal Da, Beal Sal Da, Hawk Sal Da. So, sorry, Hawk Sal Da, Beal Sal, Hawk Sal Da. So the Beal Sal is, here's your bridge. He reestablishes the bridge right there, and then he pops again. Bang. Okay? So, Noi Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal, Noi Pak Sal Da. Boom. Noi means outside. Okay, one more time, watch. Pak Sal, Beal Sal, Pak Sal. Okay, so bridge, bridge, Pak Sal, bridge again, Pak Sal again, and left and right. Got it? That's slow, easy. Here's the thing. Do it without the retreating. So Pak Pak, and then one, two, Pak Sal. So build it so you can build the structure behind the trap, and then build on managing the range in the trap very slowly. But if you don't have someone who understands what the energy is, you're just mimicking it, and it's not going to really work for you. Okay, so here's what I want you to do. Okay, I'm going to do Pak Sal Da. Pak Sal Da. Okay, he does Pak Sal Da. No, I'm going to do Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal. Okay, he does Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal. Okay, he does Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal. Okay, so. All right, now. Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal, Pak Sal Da. Okay, again. Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal, Pak Sal Da. Good. Got some of it. Pak Sal. Pak Sal Da. Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal, Pak Sal Da. He goes. Pak Sal Da. Boom. Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal Da. Boom. Okay. Pak Sal Da, Beal Sal. Pak Sal Da. Boom. Okay. Here's what I want you to think about. This shift goes side to side. This only goes up. Right? So we're both trying to go from the finger down, right? Both the finger down. Where's it gonna go? It's not gonna go from here to here. That's the feeling you should get. It's like boink, boink, boink. It's not pulling side to side. Okay? Don't get tight here. So I challenge you to do this. Listen. Hear that? So look. One, two, three. Right there. Boom. Snap your fingers as you trap. That'll slow you down. So go through the whole series. Hawk Sal Da. Hawk Sal Da. Hawk Sal Da. Beal Sal Da. Hawk Sal Da. Beal Sal Da. Hawk Sal Da. Beal Sal. Hawk Sal Da. Okay? So if I say Hawk Sal Da, what is Hawk Sal Da? Hawk Sal Da. He comes in. Hawk Sal Da. Look how far away. So Hawk Sal Da. Look how open that is. Right? So there's Hawk Sal Da here, and there's Hawk Sal Da here. What happens now? Hawk again, right? Look. So if I'm here, I go like that. That's the easier route. Right? So if he crosses the center line, that's the easier route. Or if I go to here, that's the easier route to go to that side. Right? Let's say he slips back, way back, then I can hear it. So look, when I come in here, that's the pop, double pop. Okay? So pox out da means, or pox out of pop. So I pox out of here and then pop in the inside. Okay? What is a cross so he comes in? That's across the center line. So you beal sals and then pox out da. Okay? This is to the center line, right there. And pops it up. See the difference? Watch. I slide back that far. Double pops. So, Noi pops out up. Noi pops out up. Right there. So, Noi means I pop from the outside. And then I pop from the inside. Does that make sense? So, pops out to pops out. Double pop. Same hand. So, the four is pops out right. Pak Sal left, right? That goes from side to side. The double Pak Sal is Pak Sal to Pak Sal. I go same hand to same hand. Does that make sense? And here's the thing. It's dependent upon your partner being Pak Sal's. That's it right there. Look, if I go to here, you go to there, that's what you gotta feel. Can you see the distinction between the two? He's here. I scoot back. Right there, double pop. Notice he's got to the route. The route there, straight to the rear hand. As opposed to this, if I go to here and go to there, he's got to use a rear hand to bridge and then pop his way in. Okay, so the feeder, I've got to give him, if I give him this, he's got to go across center line. Right? If I give him this, then he goes after the other hand. Does that make sense? That's the double pop set.
Depending upon the feed to give me, go to the
right. Feeder's got to give it to you. So right now, to work the double pox out, the person you're working has to give you that range to work it. Does that make sense? All right, here we go.